Okay. Our next speaker is Dr. Omaima. So she's an associate professor at the King Abdulaziz University in Jeddah. She obtained her master's and PhD at Manchester University in England. She also served as a department head of the computer science department at King Abdulaziz, and also she also served for a few years as a vice dean. Yes. And today she's going to talk about authentication in security, particularly for the Internet of Things applications. Dr. Omaima.
Thank you, Professor Kamal, for introduction, and good morning, everyone. My presentation, would be on. My presentation will be on continuous multi-factor context-aware authentication for the Internet of Things, which summarizes the research that I've done for the past 8 months under supervision of Professor Kamal Youssef Toumi. In my presentation, I will introduce the Internet of Things, and then I will discuss this application, and then the security and concerns around the Internet of Things application, with the focus on the authentication requirement, and then we'll show a use case scenario for the, to highlight the importance of authentication, and then we will introduce our protocol, and then we will describe the security and performance evaluation of the protocol, and then we will highlight the future work. Okay, Internet of Things is basically any device that has an IP address and is capable of joining the Internet. The Internet of Things are mainly composed of computers, for sure, and sensors, wireless technologies such as Wi-Fi, Zigbee's, and also the Internet. Internet of Things, which is, I'm sure that almost everyone have heard of it, it's the new hype, and it spans almost in every aspect of our daily life, starting, for example, in smart e-healthcare systems, to smart grid, to smart vehicles, to smart homes, and many more to mention. The Internet of Things has a very bright future and very promising economy. We can see this from the statistics. In 2017, they are predicted that there will be that the Internet of Things devices to be connected will triple, and also the traffic will be 20 more times than nowadays. In 2020, the number of Internet of Things connected devices range from 30 to 50 billions, with an incremental revenue 300 billions. This diagram shows the distribution of the sales of the Internet of Things devices from year 2009-2013, which you can see that it spans almost in every application of our daily life. Okay, this. Bright future and very promising comes at a price. The price always for any IT-related application is the security. Security, as highlighted by MIT Technology Review, stated that Internet of Things will create, all the devices in the Internet of Things will create a trap door for an intruder to get into the application. Hewlett-Packard Research Center found that there will be 70% of devices connected to the Internet are vulnerable to some kind of attack. And this attack has actually been happening. In the past few years, actually in the past year, in 2014, the BBC News has showed that an attack has been conducted into an LED smart light in which the attacker got hold of a Wi-Fi username and password of the smart home. And several attacks, has been happening. One of them was on a smart insulin pump injected in a patient. And there was another attack in a smart webcam installed at home. Okay, these concerns or these issues that have been arising and everywhere in the media has been a result of vulnerabilities in Internet of Things. Okay, Internet of Things are, if we can imagine it, are like thousands of devices connected to each other. These devices are all endpoints, and so there are many endpoints to be controlled and to be monitored. All these endpoints has an IP address capability. This IP address capability makes these devices can be discovered and can be hacked. These also endpoint devices are quite limited in their computational resources. For this purpose, the application developers cannot install secure cryptographic operations, and they cannot implement these kind of operations. So that they are added to the weakness of the Internet of Things. So the developers normally either ignore providing security for the Internet of Things, or they provide it with, as we say, with a grain of salt, because they think of security as a slowing down factor to the application. But we have to think about security as an enabler. So once you provide security to any application, means that you are able to execute this application in a safe environment. Sorry. So what are the security services that we need to provide so that we can have a secure Internet of Things application? The first and the most important service is authentication. Authentication means that two parties communicating with each other, they can prove the identity of each other, and then they can establish a secure communication. Once authentication is provided, all other security services can be built on top of authentication, which is confidentiality, means that information is secure and cannot be disclosed unless to the legitimate owner. Integrity means that the data is intact as it was sent from the sender and received from by receiver and has been changed, and if any change happens, can be detected. Availability means the services are there once we are needed. Okay, just to put things together, I'm going to present an example of a communication scenario in a smart home, just to shed some light on the importance of authentication in the communication of Internet of Things. In smart homes, we normally have smart meter. A smart meter is connected to home appliances, smart home appliances. Smart home appliances send their energy consumptions as a messages to the smart meter. And smart meter send command and control messages to the home appliances, or probably the homeowner can send a command and control messages to the appliances through the smart meter. Smart meter aggregate these readings and send them in batches to the data concentrator, which will send this message to the utility company. If you can see that the messages has been is broadcasted back and forth between the smart meter and the home appliances in a time intervals. Imagine that, nothing is as bright as we can see it here. Imagine that there is an attacker, okay? An attacker would steal the identity of the smart meter and the identity of the appliance, and would impersonate each one to the other without both entities knowing that there is someone there in the communication channel and impersonating these identities. So the attacker would send a message to the home, to the appliance, pretending to be the smart meter and vice versa. This attack is called man-in-the-middle attack, which is very, very famous attack in the security environment. Another type of attack that can happen is that the attacker, rather than being active in the man-in-the-middle attack, will be passive. So he will sit silently in the communication channel and will read the messages exchanged between both parties for its own benefit, which is called eavesdropping attack. A third type of attacks where the attacker would steal or would capture the message, and then will keep it and will send it in the future for its own benefit. This attack called reply attack. The fourth type of attack, and it's a very, very serious in smart grid, especially scenario, is where the attacker overwhelm for example, the smart meter with a huge number of messages sent at the same time, which make the smart meter cannot process these messages and will put it into a halt. This type of attack is called denial of service attack. So from explaining this setting, we can see that authentication is very important for each party to be assured of the identity of the other party in a scenario of a continuous messages exchange, such as in smart homes, so that these attacks cannot be or will minimize the happening of this attack or sometimes cannot be happened. So authentication here is preventing unauthorized users, like the attacker that we have seen, from accessing resources, and also prevent legitimate users from accessing unauthorized users that you are not authorized to. So it is, as we mentioned, the foundation of secure Internet of Things application. Okay, we still have a problem in the authentication provision. In the literature so far, existing solutions address the authentication from the handshake perspective. What we mean by handshake? Meaning that both parties, for example, the smart meter and the appliance, once they are set up, they will introduce each one to each other by exchanging credentials, for example, certificates, public key certificates and public keys, and perform some algorithms. These algorithms and handshake process is quite expensive because public key algorithms are very complicated and they would consume the bandwidth and the communication and the computation resources. And the other problem is that this handshake process or authenticating the parties has to be repeated each time the message is sent between the sender and the receiver. Imagine the smart home scenario. If this process will be repeated each time a smart meter sends a message to the home appliance cannot process the message, and this will cause a delay in the whole application. This, as we said, critical if we are thinking about a critical time applications. So there is a need for continuous authentication where the existing solutions has not been addressing so far. So our focus in the research was to devise a complete authentication solution for the Internet of Things, which is divided into two parts. The first part is to address the continuity part or the continuity aspect of the authentication, where we need to establish a connection or a channel between sender and the receiver, where our message are to be sent in a fast and efficient way in a continuous matter in a time specified between two parties. The second part here is the multi-factor context aware, which will be built on top of the continuous authentication, where we are going to capture the factors surrounding the application and incorporate them into the authentication and make the authentication multi-stages, so that authentication will be addressing the need. It's not one size fits all. Now we will highlight some security requirements that we need to address in our protocol, so that we are designing a complete secure authentication protocol for the Internet of Things. The first service that we need is message source authentication. As we mentioned, that when the receiver receives the message, he needs to be assured that the sender, the legitimate sender, who is the one that sent the message. We also need to provide continuous authentication, as we described earlier, and also we need to provide integrity of data, that the receiver will receive the data as it sends by the sender without being manipulated in transit. Confidentiality of the authentication token, the authentication token that is linked with the message has to be confidential, so even if the attacker can get hold of the message, cannot change the authentication token. And also we provide access control. Once the identity is authenticated, it can use the resources available. Freshness to combat the reply attack that we have mentioned, that even if the message has been captured and replied, the receiver is able to identify this attack. And there are two requirements that we are aiming, it's good to have on top of the security service, is efficiency, so that our protocol can be implemented easily on resource-limited Internet of Things devices, and scalability, so that the more devices incorporated into the protocol can be able to integrate them without much effort. Looking at existing solutions in the area, the most related work, as we can see from the paper, none of them has addressed all the security requirements that we needed for our continuous authentication protocol. And even if they addressed most of them, they addressed it from the perspective of the handshake that we mentioned, where they implemented a heavy public key cryptography for the authentication, which is not desirable in the constrained environment of the Internet of Things. Our proposed solution, the main or the general, the very abstract idea is that we want to establish, as we said, a channel between sender and receiver here, okay, where both parties agreed on a secret shared between them and a time frame, which is the session that the message is to be exchanged between two parties. The user or the sender will send a message with a burst, okay, or parts of this secret to the authenticator or to the receiver. The receiver receiving this part is able to link them to the shared secret between both parties and then to, is able to authenticate the sender. So the user will distribute or will generate shares of the secret, and each share is going to be tied with a time, so that the share will be only visible to the verifier in this time frame, and this time, specific time, is linked with the message. So K number of shares to be generated, because we are going to send K number of messages, and each share linked with the time is called an authentication token. Then the share will be bounded with the message that we want to send, and then both parts is going to be transmitted to the verifier, okay? Now the verifier has the message, has the share, a time-bound share. The time-bound share is the authenticator of the message, okay? Now the verifier will be able, after performing several verifications that I'm going to highlight in the next slide, will link the share to its originator through the token, okay? Now for the detailed description of the protocol, which I'm going to highlight quickly. As we mentioned, both parties first do the handshake, register in the registration authority, exchange their public and private key, and authenticate their identities, and will agree on the secret and the time frame that going to actually speak with each other during this time frame. Okay, the time slots has been specified according to the number of messages to be sent between two parties. And the user will then generate time flags. The time flags are actually the flags that when the time reached, the secret will be, the share will be actually sent to the verifier. And then the user will generate a time-bound secret share using Shamir secret sharing scheme. And then will generate a share authenticator. The share authenticator will play the role of linking the share to the secret here, because the secret, because the secret is the data that both parties know and both parties agreed on. So the authenticator would link this share to the secret so that the verifier will be able to authenticate the sender. After that, the user will send the whole bunch of data or message to the verifier, the message containing the identity of both parties, a timestamp to prevent reply attack, and share and the message, and a MAC of the sensitive data so that the data integrity is provided. This whole thing is sent to the verifier. The verifier will start now performing the checking and the verification. The first thing, it will check the freshness, so that the message is not replied. They will check the authenticity of the share, reveal it, and then link it to the secret so that it is actually part of the secret shared between the two parties. If all the verification has been passed positively, the verifier will send a verification outcome to the user saying that I accept the message because it is sent in the proper time with a proper share, and I was able to link it to the share, to the secret shared between both of us, and you are authenticated. If any of these checks has been turned out to be negative, also the verification outcome will indicate this to the user. As an evaluation of the protocol, we have performed security evaluation. Again, it's the security requirement that we have specified. We also performed a performance requirement, which we will highlight next. The security requirement has been met. All of them has been met in our protocol. For the performance evaluation, we have evaluated our protocol in a computational computational communication and storage. For computational costs, we have compared our protocol to the most related work in terms of the cryptographic algorithms implemented, and also the number of algorithms or number of times they have been implemented. We can see that from the table, the algorithms that we have taken to compare are hash, max, symmetric encryption, public encryption, random number generator. Our protocol enjoys efficiency in terms of the computational cost because it only utilizes hash and max, which are the most efficient cryptographic operations in comparison with the public key encryption as elliptic curve and RSA, which were implemented by the most related work. In terms of communication and storage, we have calculated, counted the number of messages exchanged between the parties, and we also calculated the length or the size of the message, given the standardization of the parameters and the key length as in the literature. From the table, we can see that our protocol has only one message sent in each direction, which the message containing the message and the authenticator and the response. Other protocols has more than two messages, and sometimes we can see that it's like 7 and 8 messages exchanged for authentication purpose only and for handshake only. In addition, our protocol enjoys an efficiency in the storage. And in storage, we mean that the memory of the Internet of Things device, because it is the weakest point in our protocol, and we are concerned to make it efficient. So the storage requirement is quite reasonable for our protocol. To further highlight the efficiency, we have taken data from a paper published in 2013 in which the author performed, they composed a test bit and performed all the cryptographic operation on this test bit to count the energy consumption of each algorithm in a microjoule per byte. From the tables, the first diagram shows the symmetric key encryption, energy consumption. The second table on the top here shows the MAC and hash algorithms, and the third table shows the public key encryption algorithms. We can see that here, the hash and MAC enjoys the least energy consumptions in all of the other algorithms, which further emphasize the efficiency of our protocol. Okay, future work would be highlighting or focusing on the second part. If you remember the diagram that I showed, continuous authentication and multi-factor authentication. So we are done with the continuous authentication part, and now we are working on the multi-factor context-aware authentication, so that to identify all the factors surrounding the authentication protocol and identify the level of sensitivity of the applications, because not all applications require the same level of authentication. Some of them require only like one level, zero level, one level, two level, and it goes up with the criticality of the application. And then we are going to define and to build a mathematical model to incorporate these factors with the criticality of the application, and then we'll integrate it with our continuous authentication to provide a complete solution. This solution is to be implemented using suitable programming and platform. The research outcome has been in a patent application and also in an IEEE conference paper. Last but not least, I would like to thank Saudi Aramco for funding this research under Saudi Aramco Ibn Khaldun Fellowship for Saudi Women in partnership with the Center of Clean Water and Clean Energy. Special thanks goes to my supervisor, Professor Kamal Youssef Toumi, for his continuous support, guidance, and thought-provoking discussions. And thanks for Kate and Teresa for their support and help and being there always for us. Thank you very much. Questions? if we have time for any. I know it's completely different. Something completely out of the track of all this, the speakers. Yes, sure.
Okay, well, if there are no questions, we can thank Dr. Omaima again, also for bringing us back on schedule. So, yeah, and I have a small award for you.
Thank you.
You can come on the side here. So, congratulations, and this is a small award. On behalf of the center and the collaboration, and also of our sponsors. Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.